I'm going to lift off the accelerator and we're going to get engine braking. We're engine braking. I'm going to take the key out of the ignition now. Nothing has changed. The car is still making sound. The exact same sound it was making before. The engine braking hasn't reduced or got harder or anything like that. That just goes to show there is no fuel being injected. Bro, the engine was off.
I'm wearing my favorite flannel shirt. You know what that means. Time to drop some education. So I was recently featured on the Real Mechanics Reactions channel. They had a look at my short about engine braking, and here's what they had to say.
Zero fuel? A life hack, just never press on the gas and you won't use any fuel.
Any fuel. No, I mean, if the car, if the engine's on, no matter what, there's gonna use fuel.
Yeah. So it will use less. Definitely not zero
it's
gas.
It's not zero, yeah, it's not zero yeah. gas. A whole lot less.
A whole lot less. Sorry, guy.
Now, I'll be honest with you guys. This just made me realize Real Mechanics can't get this concept. What hope does the average Joe like you and me have? So I wanted for once and for all to clear up this engine braking issue. In this video, we're gonna have references from scientific journals, diagrams where I actually explain what's going on under the bonnet in your car. Lots of yapping from me, including answering common questions from you guys about engine braking. POV, on-the-road examples, showing you exactly what it is I'm talking about. And just as a fifth bonus, tips about the way you can actually use this knowledge to your benefit to get better fuel economy. So let's get into it. But first, are you thinking about getting a new used car? It's probably a good idea to make sure it's not stolen, had the odometer rolled back, been damaged or crashed before you go ahead and purchase it. The best way to do that is with a CarVertical report, who have sponsored this video. Let's have a look at one of these CarVertical reports now. Just imagine you saw this advert, car looks lovely, right? Well, it has a hidden history. As you can see, this car was actually stolen. You can then see the car was actually damaged on two sides. If these cars end up on auction sites, you get the photos from when the car was damaged. Ooh, I would personally not want to buy that car. Now, I'm not Matt Armstrong. I don't want to be dealing with these underlying issues, let me tell you that. Use my discount code, mickdrives, and you can get 20% off a CarVertical report. Do you know the coolest thing about CarVertical? That they will refund your credits if you run a report on a car that is completely clean. It's one of the reasons I like doing sponsorships for this brand, because they give you genuine value. Once again, it's mickdrives, 20% off your CarVertical report. Right then, let's get back to talking about engine braking, eh? And we'll start with just a brief overview about what engine braking actually is. Now, I've done a full deep dive on the differences between engine braking and coasting, because a lot of people get confused between those two. You can click up here somewhere to watch the video. But for a brief summary in this one, engine braking is anytime you're driving and you lift off of the accelerator. Doesn't matter if you're in a manual car, an automatic car, a dual clutch car. Doesn't matter if you're in first gear, second gear, fifth gear or eighth gear or 10th gear. But importantly, your clutch needs to be engaged, which means it needs to be up, or in an automatic car, you need to be in drive, not neutral. And while you've got your foot off the accelerator, the car will slow down. That is engine braking. Now, clearly, the very hotly debated and contested issue is whether you use fuel when you're engine braking. And there is very clearly and simply a technology originally invented by Porsche called DFCO. And this is fundamental to the way engine braking works. A lot of the stuff I'm saying here is referenced from a beautiful scientific journal by the SAE Automotive Journal of Engines, where they did a ton of research on a bunch of different fuel economy topics, one of which being DFCO. There's this beautiful graph that basically shuts down any discussion about this. I'll flash it up now. You can see there's two lines, one is blue and one is green, and they both show that when there is no throttle applied, There is exactly zero fuel being injected. But to really understand DFCO and how engine braking fundamentally works, I'm going to have to get my teaching hat on and do something I've never done before, which is go to the whiteboard.
This will be the worst drawing you've ever seen, but it will make sense. You have an engine block. There are pistons inside. They move up and down, right? That's because there's a little explosion and there's a little injector spraying fuel. These drive a crankshaft. The crankshaft drives a flywheel. The flywheel is attached to a clutch. The clutch is attached to a gearbox. The gearbox is attached to a drive shaft. The drive shaft is attached to some other stuff and a hub and eventually a wheel. So when the pistons move up and down, they drive all of this, the power goes through all of this stuff to the wheel and makes it spin. All of this is attached. It's connected. If the pistons move, the wheel must move. Otherwise, something is broken. As long as you are in gear with the clutch up or in an automatic transmission, you're in drive. All of this is connected. Everything is turning together. So when you lift off of the accelerator, this car is moving. This wheel cannot stop rolling, right? Because the car is moving under its own inertia. So what happens is rather than the explosions driving this way, it works in reverse. The wheel turning, because of the inertia of the car, is actually in turn turning the engine. And because the wheel turning is turning the gearbox, which is turning the clutch, which is turning the flywheel, which is turning the crank, which is turning the pistons, there is no need for any fuel to be injected. When you lift your foot off of the accelerator, all that's happening is these pistons are just pumping air. There is a head with little valves that allow air in and out. And the wheel is moving these pistons. All they are doing is just sucking in air and blowing out air. You don't need an explosion because the engine is not powering the wheels. The wheels are powering the engine. Now, this obviously can't continue once the vehicle has no momentum. So once you start slowing down, you're at like 6 or 7 miles an hour. When your engine gets to that idle RPM where it would stall if this was to continue, all it does is very simply start injecting fuel again and just keep you moving again at that idle RPM. I'll even demonstrate this to you when we go out on the road. Deceleration fuel cut off. Decelerating, the fuel is cut off. There's no fuel. You don't need it. Please understand.
Now I would like to address some common misunderstandings or comments from across a number of videos about engine braking. Some of them come from my own videos, some of them come from the Real Mechanics video, and I just want to give you guys a little bit of credit. The vast majority of comments are actually making people understand how this technology works. But there are some repeat comments from multiple different people, so I've kind of grouped them into little buckets of the same ideology, and I'm just going to go through a few of these here. The first common comment, which is actually similar to what they said in the Real Mechanics video, is, so you just have infinite fuel now? No. What you have is the potential energy, or the momentum, or the inertia. The car is already moving. When you get down to nearly 0 miles an hour, the engine has to then start injecting fuel to keep you going. So it's not infinite fuel. It's just you using the potential energy in the car that you've already gained from accelerating. Small caveat, DFCO is only really in electronically fuel injected cars. I'm willing to bet the vast majority of people watching this channel have never even driven a carbureted car. So realistically, don't worry about it. All modern cars will have DFCO from like the early 2000s or even the late 90s and up. The second question, which actually is a genuine one, and oftentimes people are asking this in a positive way, just trying to understand, which is something must be powering the engine. And the truth is, yes, it's the potential energy in your car. It's the inertia. It's the momentum that you've already gained. There's another one, which a lot of people have said, which is quite funny to me, which is the idea of goodbye clutch or goodbye gearbox, or basically you're going to damage your car doing this. And I want to draw a very important distinction. Nobody should ever be braking with their clutch. That's just a recipe for disaster, right? And this is why people always have this phrase, brake pads are cheaper than a clutch, or brake pads are cheaper than a transmission. If you just lift off the accelerator, there's no need to say goodbye clutch. You can lift off the accelerator, come down right towards your idle RPM, dip the clutch, and then stop the last few miles an hour, and you've still got 95% the benefit of engine brake. And the final one, which is actually very funny, and this came mostly from my comments, which was, oh, well, my car's got a pop and bang map. So obviously there's some fuel because explosions are happening. Very true. This is exactly how pop and bang maps are designed. What they are doing is they are injecting fuel during that engine braking cycle. And the result is the pops and the bangs. The fact that there's no pops and bangs is almost proof that DCFO is working. Let's get into some on-the-road examples. We're at 3,000 RPM. I've lifted off. We're now engine braking. We're slowing down. But when we get down to idle, the car isn't going to just die. It's going to start injecting fuel again. So even though I don't have my foot on the accelerator, we're still creeping forward. Because it's injecting a little bit of fuel just to keep itself at idle RPM. So in this condition, it is using fuel. But during the actual engine braking, when I lift off, it stops using fuel. So right now, as it's coming down towards idle, no fuel is used. The injector duty cycle at that time is 0%. The injectors are not doing anything because they don't need to. So how do you make use of this? Well, if you see somewhere you're gonna have to stop, don't just get there and use your brakes, just lift off. Let it bring you right down to idle as you approach wherever you need to stop. I taught my wife to do this. She's getting 50 mpg in this car. This is her daily driver. 50 mpg in a big old SUV. Look at her averages. Trip one, over 3,000 miles. She's getting 47.8 mpg. You just get to know this and then suddenly you're gonna get amazing fuel economy. Why wouldn't everybody do this? Look, there's a roundabout coming up. Rather than just accelerating right up to the line and then braking, I can lift my accelerator now. I'm saving my brake pads. I'm preventing wear. I'm getting better fuel economy. And I've got more momentum to enter the roundabout if there's a good opportunity to. Even if you're in a manual car, I'm not saying you should try and hit another downshift so you can get even more engine braking. That's kind of an advanced thing. You can do that to get more engine braking, but you really don't need to. Coming into corners, I'm gonna use engine braking. If there's a tight corner coming up, I'm gonna lift off. Like this one right here. I don't really wanna go this quickly through this corner, so I'm gonna lift off. It's just gonna bring my speed down a little bit, and then I can get back on the accelerator. Rather than accelerating right up to the corner, slamming on the brakes, accelerating through again. It's just not a smooth way to drive, and you get way worse fuel economy. Even right there with the truck crossing in front of me, I'm engine braking this whole way because this situation kind of weirds me out. I don't want as much speed here because there's loads of cars around, so I want to go a little bit slower. I've been engine braking this entire time. And that means that entire run all the way down there past those cars was free. I used no fuel. You have to understand, engine braking is like a double win. While you're moving, you don't use any fuel, but then you still have the momentum when you get back on the gas. So it's a two for one. It is the ultimate cheat code for getting good fuel economy. And look at this, if you don't use engine braking in this scenario, you're just not even driving. There's a 40 mile an hour speed limit coming up. There is no reason you should drive up to that and then brake and slow down. There's another speed limit change down to 30. There is no reason you should ever come here and then brake to slow down. It makes no sense. You should be engine braking. It's like free fuel.
I don't care how well off you are. I would still take free fuel. I don't know who wouldn't. Look, there's a red light. We lift off and we engine brake all the way up to the red light. Engine braking is especially good when you can come all the way to a complete stop, because then that entire distance you use zero fuel. It's amazing. Everybody should be doing this. Well, there you go. I hope you guys learned something. I hope it wasn't too preachy, but I get really frustrated, especially when people call me out on the internet about being wrong when I'm not wrong. Thanks for watching. My name's Mick. I drive cars. Peace.